Wait, for real? Folks around here have been worried sick about her. Well, don't just stand there gawking. Where is she? The... what? You sound like you've been drinking too much of Mudtooth's tonic. You know that, right? Alright, well... is she coming back? So long as she's alright, I guess. I mean, I barely knew her. But she seemed like she could make her own choices just fine. So now that you found her, does that mean you're here to stay? I'm sorry. I just can't believe all those words were put into the same sentence, or that I even understood some of it. Our lives got pretty weird, huh? I guess we were asking for it, looking for fairy tales and all. Well, I ain't going nowhere then. I'll be here when you need me, or when you're done, whichever comes first. Just make sure you come back, okay? Hey, you're back! Debt's still at 2 now. Remember that. A whole other world. How many of these are there? Find these segments, huh? While Clementine and that talking ball of light hang out and meditate. Sure. Sounds fair.
Seen upon Yaesha for long and long. The pestilence takes me. Or is it now simply part of what I am? It's been so long. The difference hardly matters. But the Paxeltak, how comes it here, to Yaesha? Slumber. The pestilence think of them often, especially the stones of the Paxeltak's earth. I am Bedell of the Vaunt. When this world was young, the Pan did service to the green and growing things. Now, the Pan betrays the world. And the world, the wolf, betrays the Pan. A ravager, plague of the Pan, and defiler of the Doe. The wolf hunts all, yet is itself unhunted. To the shame of all Pan. Once part of the balance, the immortal ravager has cast aside this world and pledged fealty to the pestilence that would destroy all worlds. And the Red Doe, that which held the ravager in check for long and long, has not been seen in an age. If it seeks to save its own life and world, the Paxeltak must hunt the Ravager and end it. The beast is not alone. The Lamir have given themselves to it in service. Once servants of the Eternal Empress, many Lamir have been seduced by the Ravager's blood-soaked tongue and thus betrayed the Pan. Beware, Paxeltak. They will fight until the beast's final breath. I can assure the Baxeltech it will be nothing of the sort. Trade? Perhaps. Money is of little use to me for obvious reasons, but others may find value in what the Baxeltech may leave behind. Take what it will, Baxeltech. But leave something it considers of equal value. A sacrifice to the balance. And a gift to the man.
Is it over?
Summons me from my ethereal wanderings.
Luzar! What kind of beast is this? Paxel Tech. I can share my wanderings with you. But first, I seek the knowing, the truth of nature held within your ark. You want to answer? So I will ask. Answer these questions true. Sweet beast, so that your ark may be known and your eye may open. And do choose wisely. Answer from your heart. You have fallen madly in love with an immortal. Your love for them is so strong, you know them to be your destiny. To be with them, you may eat from the tree of life and become immortal as well. But your family and everyone else you care for cannot partake. They must grow old and eventually die. Do you abandon your mortal family? Or live out your days without your one true love? Oh, what fun this is! Brutes have seized your village with intent to kill. You and your clan have taken refuge in the cellar of a large house. A babe threatens to cry out. In haste, you cover the child's mouth. The child cannot properly breathe, But if you remove your hand, the warriors will find you. Do you risk smothering the child to save yourself and the others? Ha! Oh dear. No bother, it's nothing. Moving on. Consider that it is you who discovers the Thane, the tree that offers immortality to all who eat its fruit. You could share this gift with all, but doing so may lead to war and embitterment, to the immortality of those who do not deserve it and will only abuse eternal life. Or you could limit immortality to the deserving and thus, through the deserving, bring a better life for all. Do you give immortality to all, or only a chosen few? It's not every day a question determines the course of your destiny. Or is it? You preside over the trial of an innocent. Enemies of the accused have kidnapped your child and hold her hostage, saying that if you convict the accused, they will set your daughter free. Do you convict the innocent, or risk your daughter's life? Ooh, how revealing. Your vessel sinks at sea, and there is only one skiff. It cannot hold every soul aboard, and now sits dangerously low in the water. The sea becomes rough, and the skiff begins to fill. If nothing is done, it will sink before rescue arrives, and everyone on board will drown. There are a few injured souls who may not survive until rescue reaches you anyway. If you let them drown, the rest of you will likely survive. Do you throw the injured souls overboard, or risk letting the skiff sink? You'd be surprised how little I hear that response. You have chosen your path, sweet beast. Your will is strong. The fire of the Ravager's eye glows within you. In the arc of every being, there are two eyes. We may see out of either, but most favor one over the other. The Ravager's eye is dynamic, driven, and endlessly hungry. Yet for all its power, its vision is clouded. The eye of the Ravager rarely sees beyond its own satiation. Like an animal chasing its tail, it knows no rest. The Doe's eye sees only what is before it. The gift of the Doe is subtle, easily missed. It is a most mysterious presence inside oneself, conferring power without force, just as the Doe itself cannot be sought, nor tracked, nor hunted. By answering true, sweet beast, you give me a wink, and now the gifts of your dominant eye will be open to you. Would you care to hear a tale? It is about those who see as you do. I will tell you the tale of Belgov, who also saw with the Ravager's eye. Belgov lived in the era before the Root first bedeviled the Pan and nipped at their hairy hooves. Belgov was drinkmaster of Flint, a village beyond the hill. One day, when Belgov was traveling far afield, Flint was raided by bandits. They laid waste to every soul, old and young. Belgov returned to find everyone he cared for watering the soil with their blood. Well, Belgov tapped his store of spirit, filling Growler and Jerobone by the gaggle, and he hoofed himself to my grove. Where lies the bandit's lair? He demanded. His eye was open, and I had no reason to deceive him. At my direction, Belgov tintinnabulated to their den. There, He smashed a jug on his horns and struck flint with steel, and Belgov was reborn as a flaming figure of vengeance. He charged into the bandit's lair, hoof over hand, and in his enemy's bosom, the remaining stock of spirit took spark with explosive result. Some consider this a waste of life, for could not Belgov have traveled elsewhere and rebuilt what he had lost? But I'll tell you this. Flynn's sister village stood free from bandit attacks for many years after that day. Belgov's blaze of glory saved it. He died with the Ravager's eye open and no mercy in his heart. Terrible waste to drink, though. Is there anything else? Knowledge of me? Of our wonderful world? You stand before Myrdra, spirit of the natural world, daughter of stem and stream. My sisters and I are the glorious weavers of all wild beauty. When mountain, spring, and sturdy tree trunk take your breath, sweet beast, that is us. That is our blessing. An immeasurable number. Mother stem and mother stream rely on us to sprawl and grow. Though we don't often commune with beasties such as you. Not in this age. Especially not since what happened to Kaola. A tragedy, beast. Tragedy most cruel. Kaola was fascinated by mortals. By your lives and stories. Unlike most of us, she made herself no secret. And you worshipped her with your short lives. Even built her a house. A temple, you called it. The root found her there. We godlings are not easily unwoven, however. And it slew her not. But perhaps it would be better if it had. For what remains is no longer the sister I knew. But we hold happy thoughts. Regret only wastes one life with another. Is there something else we can talk about? By day, a dappled glade of emerald branch and golden leaf, carpeted by downy moss. By night, sweet beast, the trees bewitch the lost and inebriated. Or so it was before this age of extermination. How I long to return to play. This age, for me, holds only decay. Fang and claw be with you.
How goes it, friend? Take care, my friend.
Thank you. the hell happened here?
Great. More bad news.
Yeah.
bags full. Out of room. won't fit. Yeah!
That's it. For now. This isn't looking good. Yeah. Not bad.
Thank you.
Glad that's over.
Oh, Batsultek. We must speak again. Friend Batsultek, it returns. And of course it has. Long ago the Batsultek and I spoke of songs and... Ah, of course. It is not the same Batsultek. Forgive me. The horns. It does not have them. A new friend, then. Hmm? So what brings it to beleaguered Yaesha? Truly? Then it treads the very path it seeks. The ancient temple was built to imprison such a beast. It now serves as its lair. Alas, the great water harp, which tales tell once opened the temple, has been shattered for an age and an age. There is no hope without its song. Yet beware, friend Batsultek, for the Ravager has been killed before. There is none more powerful than that which shakes off death like fallen leaves. Of course. Quite so. Batsultek have graced this world for generations. The Elder, the one it calls for. The Destroyer, to whom many faces fell. The Wanderer, who faced the Ravager and lived. Alas, songs are not song of Batsultek, but I am blessed to have met many. Its kind bring this one joy and song. I seek hope. Friend Batsultek, Yaesha is broken. Corruption waxes while the tree wanes. The balance groans in pains of birth. Yet through it all, the song of Aethir has hung in the air. One could always hear it in the wind and water, sand and star. I came to the temple hoping to hear its melodies once more. Not on the wind, but in plain truth, as it was meant to be. Alas, I fear the song is lost forever. destined to live in memory alone. There is much to tell, though, alas, I am no scholar. Suffice to say, the Ravager and Doe are the heart of this world, the very essence of the balance. The Doe is life, the Ravager, death, each necessary in equal measure, if the Lamir are to be believed. Yet now, the Ravager serves the rot, the corruption that ingests Yaesha piece by piece with each passing day. I do not know what will become of our mother, but I trust the songs. So long as we have music, we have hope. Ah, a tragic tale woven into many ballads. The story of the Water Harp is the story of Yaesha and the Balance. It is the story of the Pan. The great wolf, the Ravager, decimated our people. It was said that it could not be killed, for to do so would upset the balance and bring upon us even worse calamities. So the harp was fashioned to soothe the beast with music. And soothe it did, but only for a time. The beast escaped, silencing the harp in the process, ending its song for long and long. The beast is chaos, and the balance ineluctable. The balance does not concern itself merely with life and death, love and hate, freedom, suppression. The balance governs all. May it return again.
This looks important. This looks important. Looks important. looks important.
This looks important. This looks important.
This looks important. Looks important. This looks important.